across the yard.
The Weather Channel. No place on earth has better weather.
We'll check on our tropical update right now. Will Annan, along with Vivian Brown, at 50 minutes past the hour. We'll take a look at, first of all, the big globe and show you what's happening. A very intense hurricane right now. Guillermo is on its trek off towards the west at the present time, and you can see it has a very distinct eye. We'll show you a closer view coming up in just a second. And we do think this is going to have some impact on Hawaii. A direct hit, probably not. But large swells, yes, and we could also see some large swells affecting Southern California from Guillermo within the next day or two. The latest stats on Guillermo right now, as of 2 o'clock this morning, Pacific Daylight Time, 14.4 north, 120.3 west, or about 890 miles to the southwest of Cabo San Lucas, Mexico. Top sustained winds now, 160 miles per hour. Still gusting up to 195 miles per hour. That's going to generate some swells. And it's moving westbound right now at 16 miles per hour. Yesterday at this time, moving west at about 13 miles per hour. So overall, about the same rate of movement now to the west, again from 13 to 16 miles per hour. A closer view, let's show you what's going on. Take a look at that eye right there. Isn't that a beautiful picture? Very distinct eye. We've got a very healthy hurricane right now, the strongest one right now in the past 26 years. It is down to 921 millibars, the pressure, and the strongest one by recorded history, by the way, over the eastern Pacific Ocean was back in June of 1973, and that was Hurricane Eva, which had a pressure of 915 millibars. So a strong hurricane right now, Category 5, and you can see the well-distinct eye. It's on the move right now to the west. This is Baja California, the Hawaiian chain, a long ways away from Hawaii right now, but it's going to generate some swells as far westward as Hawaii within the next couple of days. East-facing islands for sure, and east-facing shores. And watch out for Southern California, too. You can be getting some swells from this one as well. But it's on the move and should be moving into colder waters within the next 48 hours, which means it's going to be losing a lot of its energy source, the warm tropical waters. So we could be looking at this thing beginning to fizzle out very slowly, starting in about another 24 to 36 hours. Let's show you what else is happening around the world.
We can be interested in some extreme weather, and the extreme feature that we have to talk about is Guillermo. And here you can see it here. That's why we're showing you the western hemispherical shot. And there it is. Look at the outflow here over Guillermo. And you can even see the eye on Guillermo, too, if you look real close. And we'll get in closer with this now. As of 8 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time, this is the very latest from the Hurricane Center, 14.5 north, 121.6 west, about 950 miles away from any land area in Mexico. Top winds, though, 160 miles an hour, gusts to 195 miles an hour, Category 5 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. And the good news is it's moving west 16 miles an hour away from any land areas. And look at this picture. Is that amazing? Look at the outflow around the storm. And right here, this is where we have those winds, 160 miles an hour, sustained gusts to 195. It's about as powerful as storms we've seen in quite a while here, but as strong as they get in this part of the world. And look at the eye. That is amazing. We also have another shot to show you, and that's our first visible shot of the day. And there it is. Look at that. There you can see the eye right in here. Look at that. That is a monster. And right here, this is where we have the bulk of those extreme winds. And thank goodness this is out over the land. Okay, let's go back to the infrared shot. And again, you can see it just churning away. It's a buzzsaw moving out across the Pacific. Downstream, the Hawaiian Islands. If this was to continue on its present course, it'll get close to the Hawaiian Islands, looks like around Sunday, but in a much, much weakened state. Water temperatures cool a little bit out here. Signs of that, some of the stratus right here, this lighter shade of gray. So as this moves westward, it will slowly start to weaken. By the time it gets near the islands, it'll be in a much, 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 much weakened state. Okay, now closer to home, we have that circulation around our hurricane here, and the flow starting to push the swells northward. Already getting reports of some sets coming on in here at about 6-7 feet south-facing beaches of Southern California. Swells really come on in earnest tonight and tomorrow, and right into Thursday. Should be very rough with the huge swells coming on in, generated by rainfall.
The blue in the middle is the eye, indicates much warmer temperatures. We could just about see down to the ocean's surface on this hurricane because the eye is relatively clear. We go to the visible presentation, and this three-dimensional entity you could see here looks like a donut. It's called the central dense overcast, and it's circular, and it's got a good radius around the eye. And then again, the way we evaluate these for intensity is looking at the satellite photograph, because we don't have any direct observations right now. And that kind of symmetry indicates Category 5 on the Saffir-Simpson scale, or 155 miles an hour or greater. We could go even tighter now and show you, again, that eye wall with what could be called a stadium effect. It's very possible that this would be the stadium effect, which is a teacup shape to the interior of the eye. A beautiful sight to behold for the folks that fly in there. Nobody's in there right now, but you could see right to the ocean surface in that clear eye. So it's moving off to the west-northwest and just about as intense as a hurricane can get. Thankfully, it's not affecting any land masses. Let's
seldom see in the Atlantic Ocean or the Eastern Pacific a hurricane more powerful than Hurricane Guillermo. Centered at 14.5, 121.6 west, that's 950 miles south of Cabo San Lucas, which is right at the tip of Baja California here. It is moving away from land now toward the west about 16 miles per hour. Top winds are 160 miles an hour. That makes it a Category 5 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. That is as high as the scale goes. And the estimated pressure is 921 millibars. Now, we've had a couple hurricanes hit the United States with a lower pressure than that. We've had the Keys hurricane of 1935, and Hurricane Camille of 1969 had about a 905 pressure. This is 921. To compare that to Andrew, for example, and you remember the damage that Andrew did in South Florida, the landfalling pressure there was 922 millibars. Now, we can show you a satellite picture, and we can show you this very beautifully formed eye on the infrared, the red showing you where some of the higher tops are. And in the upper atmosphere, we can see perfect, almost on ideal outflow, which is kind of a textbook case. Now, this is a long way, say, from Hawaii. We'll talk about that in just a minute. And we do have good reason to think that it is going to weaken before it gets all the way to Hawaii. This is yet another picture of it. This is a visible picture. We can begin to see the shadow now on the eye walls. The sun comes around to the other side, moving, as we said, toward the west at about 16 miles per hour. Now, we'll show you a different picture here so you can get the full perspective to Hawaii. Here's the eye of the hurricane, and there's the Big Island of Hawaii. Now, that is about a little over 2,000 miles away, and it would not be able to get to the vicinity of the Hawaiian Islands that we think before Sunday, very likely late Saturday or Sunday, so it's got a long way to go. And we have reason to think that there will be significant weakening of this hurricane before it gets to Hawaii. And one way to show you that is to look at this map of sea surface temperatures, and we call your attention to the Pacific area. Right there on the edge of the Big Island of Hawaii, the hurricane is located right here, and those deep reds you see are well above 80 degrees, but you see it's got to pass over where you see the yellow color there, and that temperature there, the sea surface temperature, is going to be in the low 70s. Now, we found out that in order for a hurricane to develop or to sustain itself, it needs to be over water about 80 degrees Fahrenheit or a little warmer. So it's going to be substantially cooler. So we do think it'll weaken. So we're not sure what we'll have exactly by the time it gets to Hawaii, but could even, we hope, be below hurricane strength. And maybe if we're real lucky, it'll be below tropical storm strength, 155. So technically, it's no longer a Category 5, but a high Category 4. To compare that, say, with Andrew, the lowest pressure on Andrew was 922 millibars. But the important thing for us is that it's moving away from land. It's moving toward the west about 16 miles an hour. We expect to see it continue to do that. We don't see any change. We think eventually we're going to see a motion a little bit more toward the west-northwest. And we should point out to you that it's still more than 2,000 miles away from the first island in Hawaii. It's about more than 2,000 miles away from Hilo, as a matter of fact. We'll show you the satellite picture, and the first we'll show you the infrared, where We've enhanced the cloud tops and showing you where the coldest cloud tops are, the red colors, and the eye where it's warm, so no color there at all. Very heavy precipitation there is generating tremendous waves. It's a classical hurricane in every sense of the word. As we look at the visible picture, we can see that it has perfect outflow. If you were going to draw a picture of a hurricane in a textbook and show you what it should look like, both in the low levels and upper levels, this just about fills the bill. But it's really an awesome thing if this kind of a hurricane would ever hit land. Now, is there any land in danger? Well, let me put you in this kind of perspective here. There's the eye of the hurricane. There's the big island of Hawaii. We feel quite confident that this hurricane is going to weaken and weaken by a significant amount before it could get anywhere near the Hawaiian Islands. As we said, it's about 2,000 miles away. Well, you might wonder, well, why are we so sure? Why do we think it's going to weaken? Well, we think it because of the sea surface temperatures. And I wanted to show you a map here. And this is courtesy of our friends in the Navy, the Fleet Numerical Meteorological Oceanic Center there. And these are the temperatures. The hurricane is situated right about there now, and you see the bright red colors there. Well, that temperature is over 80 degrees Fahrenheit. But it goes toward the west. It's going to encounter the yellow area here to the east of the Hawaiian Islands. And the temperatures are low there. They're perhaps even in the low 70s. And we know that a hurricane needs sea surface temperatures of, say, 80 degrees Fahrenheit or a little warmer to either for the hurricane to develop or to sustain the hurricane. So we think we will see significant weakening there. Hopefully this will be down even below a hurricane and even below a tropical storm. Now we have quite a lot of time to watch it. We don't think it would be in the vicinity of Hawaii before Sunday. So lots of time to watch. Now we would want to point out though that it is going to be sending swells to the west two or three days before it gets there. So you're going to have some very significant swells no matter if the storm weakens on the eastward facing beaches in the Hawaiian Island chain. Now,